Let us solve one problem on paging. And this particular problem, whatever you have selected, it came in the GATE exam in the year 1998. But the problem is very much relevant, and these sort of problems are very frequent in coming. So what is the problem? The problem here is that in an instruction, if an instruction takes I microseconds and the page fault takes additional J microsecond, that means if there is no page fault, if you are accessing only the memory, then it is taking I microsecond, and if a page fault has occurred, then it is taking say J microseconds. The effective instruction time, if on the average a page fault occurs every K instruction, that means you are supposed to calculate the effective instruction time, also known as effective accessing time. So effective accessing time or effective instruction time, you are supposed to calculate. And another information has been provided, a page fault occurs every K instructions. So how to solve this one? It's a very simple problem, not a big deal. So you know that I can write in this way, effective instruction time. So effective instruction time is equal to normal execution time plus average page fault time or page fault service time. So that is the expression. So effective or the normal execution time is quite simple. So the normal execution is I microsecond. But what about the average page fault service time? So you see, page fault occurs at every k seconds. So the probability of page fault is equal to 1 by k. So page fault occurs at every k seconds. So the probability of occurrence of page fault will be 1 by k. So that is the thing. And this average page fault service time, this average page fault service time can be defined in this way. So that is my average page fault service time is equal to J by K. Why average page fault service time is J by K? Because it is nothing but J is the, we are having this one. So J microsecond will be there for page fault to be additional time required for the J microsecond. So J microsecond is the additional time required, and probability of occurrence of page fault is 1 by K. So J by K will be the time for average page fault service time. So the normal execution time is nothing but I. So normal execution time is nothing but I. It is already written I microseconds normally. So the effective instruction time will be I plus J by K. So that will be the expression, I plus J by K. So I think the things are clear to you, because every K second there will be one page fault. So page fault probability will be 1 by K. And the page fault service time is J. So the page fault, for each page fault it is J. So the page fault, average page fault service time will be J into 1 by K. And normal execution time, normal accessing time is this I. So effective instruction time will be I plus J by K. So I plus J by K. Okay. So I've got this one. Now let me check the answer. Yeah, I plus J by K. So what are the other options? Obviously, they are not valid. So I plus J by K is the time. So in this way, in case of paging, these sort of problems may come. Please try to solve such problems, other types of problems in this particular category, and get more confidence. Thanks for watching this video.